Welcome to this video lecture where we are going to see how to evaluate a Fourier series in an interval minus L, L. First, let us see the formula of Fourier series in an interval minus L to L, which is a general interval of period 2L. So, this is the trigonometric series. A naught by 2 plus summation an cos n pi x by l plus summation bn sin n pi x by l. So remember, in 0 to 2 pi we had cos nx and sin nx instead of n pi x by l, but it is very similar to that, because here in the place of l, if we substitute pi, what we get? Cos nx and sin nx. So it is of the same form. That was for period 2 pi, and this is for period 2L. And next we have the formulas for the Fourier constants A0, An, and Bn. So learn the formula. This is specifically for the interval minus L to L. Now let us start doing problems in this type. Look at the first one. Evaluate the Fourier series for the function 0 in minus L to 0, L in 0 to L. So when you observe this function, this is not going to be an even function, or it's not going to be an odd function also. So this is a type neither even nor odd. So the Fourier series is given by all the three terms. We will have f of x equal to a naught by 2 sigma a n cos n pi x by l sigma b n sin n pi x by l. And we'll move on to all the formulas, a naught, a n, and b n formulae given by Euler's. First, let us find a naught. What is the formula for a naught? 1 by l minus l to l f of x dx. And what is our function f of x given? 0 in minus L to 0, L in 0 to L. Now look at this. We need to split the integration minus L to L like minus L to 0 plus 0 to L, because the function is given differently in these two ranges. So we have splitted the integration like this. From minus L to 0, the value of f of x is 0, plus from 0 to L, the value of f of x is L. Now let us integrate this. So it is just going to be 0 to L, L into dx, because the first integral is going to be 0. So 1 by L into integral dx is x from 0 to L. And when we apply the limit, we get L minus 0, because in the place of x, we have to put upper limit L minus lower limit 0. Hence, the value of A naught is L. Now let us move on to find the next Fourier constant, An. This is a formula for An. 1 by L minus L to L f of x cos n pi x by L dx. Now as usual, this minus L to L integral we have to split into two halves. That is, first one, from minus L to 0, the function is 0, plus from 0 to L, the function is L. So we have substituted like this. Next, so this is going to be just the second integral alone will come, because the first integration is 0. Now let us see how to integrate this. L and L getting cancelled, we have this term. Now remember, when we integrate cos, what we will get? Sine. Yeah. So cos, when we integrate, we will get sine ax by a. That is a formula. So here in the place of a, we have n pi by l. So that is a constant. So sine n pi x by l divided by, what is the constant? N pi by l. So that will come in the denominator from 0 to l. So now apply the limit. What is the upper limit? In the place of x, we have to put l. So we get sine n pi minus the lower limit is, putting x equal to 0, what we get? Sine 0. And divided by n pi by l, I have written as l I have taken to the numerator. So the value is ultimately 0, because sine n pi is 0. Similarly, Similarly, let us move on to find the last Fourier coefficient Bn, and this is the formula for Bn. As usual, split into two halves. From minus L to 0, the function is 0. From 0 to L, the function is L. So it will have just one term, L into sine nπx by L dx. Again here, L and L will get cancelled. So you get this. And when we integrate sine, what we get? Minus cos, right? So this, when we integrate, what we will get? Minus cos nπx by L divided by that constant. What is the constant? Nπ by L. Now we shall apply the limit. The upper limit is, in the place of x, when we substitute L, we get cos nπ minus cos nπ minus lower limit. What is the lower limit? In the place of x, when we put 0, we get cos 0. So the denominator by nπ by L, that L had gone to the numerator. Now remember the values of cos nπ and cos 0. Cos 0 1, and cos nπ is minus 1 power n. So substitute these values in Bn, we get 1 minus 1 power n divided by nπ. Now this is a very peculiar term, that is 1 minus 1 power n. Whenever we have such terms, we can observe it will be 0 either for odd integers or for even integers. So here in this case, this Bn term is getting 0 whenever n is even. So you can observe 1 minus 1 power n. When n is 2, what we get? 1 minus 1 squared. It's going to be 0. So likewise, minus 1 power 4, minus 1 power 6, etc. When it becomes, the value of Bn is going to be 0. And whenever n is odd, the numerator will become 2 divided by nπ. So we have all the values got, a0, an, and bn. So let us substitute in the Fourier series. We have the Fourier series of f of x is, remember the first term was a0 by 2. So L by 2 plus an is 0, so second summation is 0. Third term we have sigma bn sine nπx by L. So in the place of bn, we are writing 2 by nπ. And of course, it is not n equal to 1 to infinity now. Since the values of bn are available only for odd integers, we are writing as n equal to 1, 3, 5, etc. till infinity. So students, I hope you would have learned how to evaluate Fourier series in an interval of the type minus L, L. So kindly use the techniques what you have learned in the lecture and try these problems. In this lecture, we learned how to evaluate Fourier series in the interval minus L, L. In the next class, let us learn about Fourier series of even and odd functions in the same interval minus L, L.